Hello and welcome to Design Inc. This is the fifth in a series of tutorials where we are setting up an interior design dashboard in Notion. If you've missed the first four tutorials, I encourage you to take a look at these so you can build along. It would be easy just to give you the template, and I will, for free, once I finish the build out. If you want a copy of the template, sign up for my newsletter. The link is in the description and you'll be the first to get access to it. I think this will be a series of 10 videos. I'm trying to keep them around 10 minutes long, but maybe a little bit more or a little bit less. And if you don't want to miss a video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Anyway, let's get started. In this tutorial, we're going to set up a standard operating procedure database and a template that we can use to document our process. Before we start any standard operating procedure, we should take a look at the whole procedure. I like to map it out visually. You can use an app like Whimsical, Miro, or Milanote to do this. Let's take a look at one that we have here. I'm going to map out a standard operating procedure for creating a blog post for my interior design website. I've created a template in Milanote and built it out. So let's take a look. Here is a Milanote which I've created, and you can see here I've actually created, if you look at the homepage, a template which then I have duplicated. I've created a board, and you can then create your SOPs within a board on Milanote. It's always good practice as you are doing your standard operating procedures to create a board like this. It really helps you think through the stages. If we go into our SOP boards, I've created a board for blog posts, and in this blog post I have just an image to make me remember what it is, and then we need this procedure to ensure we've covered all our tasks. I can add in the link to the blog posts or any research, and you can also add a link to a Loom. You might want to either make a Loom video that actually explains it. It's quite nice to document it with something like Loom and then go back and write the list of tasks. The other way that you can do it is by just creating a mind map. Let's say we want to do this particular thing, and then we know this is what we want to do next. We can drag in an arrow and say, let's say we're not quite sure about the order. We say, okay, this is what we do next. But at the same time, we've got to do this. For example, we want to write our blog posts. And at the same time, we might be wanting to do our own writing. But also, we might have this for a VA, prepares images. We might want to list out what kind of images do we have. We've got thumbnails, we've got the Pinterest posts. You might also want to create something for your blog post for your social media.
Now, once we've finished this, we can then hop back into Notion and take a look at how to set up the database and the template.
Let's just have a look at the standard operating procedures database that I have already created. We have a name, the type of standard operating procedure, who it's for, the status, the last time we updated, and this is important because we want to know that it's as new as possible, who created it, and then we have our links so we can actually link it to the other databases that we've already created. We created the context database, the knowledge database, and the master links database. We've yet to create these two databases, so we'll do that later. And this last column, we're actually linking back to this database here by relating any other standard operating procedures that might be part of a bigger project. If we have a look here, we've got our knowledge database, and we're also going to link back to that standard operating procedures database. We'll start by building this out. We'll head over to our dashboard, and we are going to create an SOP, and we're going to make it into a page. Open that up so we can add an icon. You can add whatever you want. Let's say it's a checklist. So let's just make it that. And we're going to make it into a table. And We're going to create a new database. And we have our names. Here we're going to make it into a type. We can make it into a multi-select or a select, but I think I'm going to make it type. And then we can add in a couple of, we might say here it's social media. It could be for a client. We could make it for, so it might be internal. It could be something like billing, time. You can make whatever is meaningful to you and that you can use to actually create filters here. The next thing we're going to do is, this relates to the stages in our design journey. So I'm going to leave that for the moment, and I'm just going to add in the last update. So we're going to change that to last update. I like to just change the date format, and I'm Australian, so it's day, month, year, but you can change it to whatever suits you. Then I also would like to add in a person. So I'm going to write who created it by. Then we've got our roles. This is more, the roles is people who you'd like to be looking at this. For example, if you've got a list of specific operating procedures for people who are VAs, you can tag them in that way. You could make this into a select column. So then you can filter it to all the tasks that are appropriate to that particular role. But we're just going to keep this here as a placeholder. And obviously we can change it to any kind of property that we'd like. We want to add in a status, and here we can add in as not started, but we want to probably make it active. And we can make this the default. So let's just set it as the default. And then we can keep that one there if you want. And then you can say whether, if it's inactive, I'm just going to add one here. We might want to actually add in archive. We might also want to add in here where it says needs updating. So we can change that to needs updating, and we can also add in an in progress. Then we want to add in our relationships, so we're going to add in a relation here, and we're going to link it to our knowledge base. Then we're going to add in here the relation contacts. And we'll just add that relationship. And then we've got our master links. So we add our relation and our master links. So we're going to add a relationship there. So we've got those relations. We're also going to create these two that I've highlighted in yellow a little bit later. And in the last column, we want to have our related standard operating procedures. We're going to create, and we're going to link it to this database. And we're going to, we don't need to have separate directions. We might want to just add in something here and save it. You can see down here, we've got our standard operating procedure, our master link database, and we've got our knowledge base up here. As we can see here, we've really connected everything. Let's just hop back into it and let's create a new standard operating procedure. We're going to create a new template. And the important thing about a template is, and I want to just have a look at my Notion site here. Let's have a look at this. Now, you can see here, this is a template. And what I've actually done is built out the
template to include all of these sections. The first thing we want to do is to actually add in, this is the SOP template, and I always put a plus sign at the beginning so that I know that it's a template. And then I'm going to put our task and procedure name, and then I'm going to have a call out, and I'm going to have an explanation video. This could be a Loom video. I'm going to record Loom video and embed here. We can just type in, and then we've got another call out. And then we can make it an organization. We call it our flow chart. If you've created it in Whimsical, you can embed it. You can even create your Milanote into here where you've actually created it graphically. We're going to just embed flow chart here. And then we're going to talk about how we want to use it. So for frequency, how many times we're using it. We want our use case. And this is where we have our task list. So what we're going to do is actually link out the tasks. So let's just do a to-do list. So we're going to have task one, task two, task three, and then we're going to add in some links. Now you can style this any way that you want. Let me just quickly style this one. So we want to go make that, let's make it orange. And then here, I'm just going to go back here because sometimes we want to edit again. If you want, you can create, make that clear, and you can then move that into here. And then it's all in here. And if you want to just change the default color to default background, you can see you can actually embed squares into squares. So let's create the template for the standard operating procedure. In this template, I just want to make it easy to fill out. And I think it's important that you actually have steps where you're recording a video or some sound bite that someone can actually follow along. It's always helpful to add it visually. I've left a space here where you can actually record a Loom video and you can embed it here. Or if you use Vimeo, you can actually embed a video link here. And when we are creating our flowchart, we can actually embed, and you can see in this example, I've embedded a whimsical chart into the actual procedure. And then we can talk about what the frequency is, and you can style this page any way you like, but I think it's important that you actually make sure a structure to this template. As you can see, you can just style it however you want. I'm just gonna make this into here, and we could put that side by side. You can make these toggle headings here, turn into a toggle heading and make it orange. So let's make that a gray background with orange. I like to use dividers, so we can have that there, and then we can add in our links again. So let's just turn that into a heading two, and also give that a divider. You can add in any way that you would like to set up this page. And then once we've got this, we can then fill out our standard operating procedure according to the board that we have created in the past. So I hope this has been helpful with setting out the standard operating procedures. As I said before, we are going to link these standard operating procedures into the knowledge base. So if, for example, you're doing something on a blog post and it's related to Squarespace, for example, then you might have a whole knowledge base on Squarespace telling you how to do things, and you might link back to that knowledge base within your standard operating procedure. If someone needs a little bit of help, if they want to know how to do something in particular that might be minor, it's not quite an operating procedure, it's just maybe how to log into a particular page or whatever, you can then link it into that knowledge base.
Now that we have created this standard operating procedure database, we can create as many procedures as we wish. A thorough and complete system means that we can spend less time managing tasks and can ensure quality control throughout the process. We can record our operation once on Loom and then upload it to our database to be retrieved whenever we wish. We've done a few of the hard yards here, and the progress may seem slow, but by now we know a lot about databases and how they are so powerful at storing information. In the next tutorial, we're getting to the good part, setting up the client side of the business. We already have set up our client in our context database, so in the next tutorial, we're going to set up our client project pipeline. This pipeline will help us track the progress of our project. We'll also create specific client templates in our contacts database. So, don't forget to hit the subscribe button so you don't miss a thing. I can't wait to get started on the rest of the build out. See you in the next video.